Hi, this is Chelsea from Ref and Write. In this video, we will learn how to write the abstract section of your research paper. The abstract is one of the most important sections of your research paper. People normally see your abstract first because it will be available in conference programs and various databases. This section should be the last thing you write because this is a summary of the entire paper along with your final conclusions. The abstract is like a mini paper. The abstract should be self-sufficient, and just by reading the abstract, the reader should get a rough idea of what you have done in the paper. Here are three reasons why you should spend a decent amount of time writing your abstract. Number one, the abstracts are available for free. Readers will read the abstract first and then decide whether to purchase the full version of the paper or not. Number two, after submitting your paper to a journal, the editor reads the abstract and decides whether to send your paper for review or to reject it. Number three, the reviewers read the abstract first. If it is badly written, then they won't bother wasting time reading the rest of the paper. They will assume that the rest of the paper will be equally bad and will reject the paper. So it is very important that the readers have a positive reaction to your abstract. The abstract should clearly answer the following questions. Number one, why you are writing this paper? Number two, what did you do? Number three, what are your results? Number four, what are the implications of your findings? There are two types of abstracts, structured abstract and unstructured abstract. Most journals follow the unstructured format. This is basically writing your abstract as a continuous paragraph. However, some journals follow a structured format. You are expected to structure your abstract under different headings. Let's look at an example abstract that is written in both structured and unstructured formats. This is an abstract from a medical research paper. The authors are starting with a topic and the problem definition. They are saying that vitamin D and obesity appear to be linked, and it is unclear if vitamin D supplements will contribute to weight loss among obese patients. Then they are explaining the method. They conducted a randomized clinical trial with 100 participants. The trial went on for 24 weeks and they measured BMI during the study. Then they move on to the results. They are saying that they found a significant difference in BMI between the vitamin D group and the placebo group. Finally, they talk about the implications of their study. They are saying that their study has provided evidence that vitamin D can be used as a therapeutic option for weight loss programs. The abstract nicely summarizes the essence of the paper. After reading it, you know exactly what to expect from the paper. Now let's look at the same example written in a structured format. The abstract is structured under four headings. Number one, background and objectives. Number two, methods. Number three, results. And number four, conclusions. Please check your journal requirements before you start writing your abstract, as many journals in the field of health sciences require a structured abstract. Here is another example. This example is from an engineering research paper. The authors are starting with the topic. They are saying that their topic relates to removing errors from digital video. Then they are explaining the method. The authors are saying that they have proposed a new technique that can fix these errors automatically. Then they are presenting the results. They are saying that their methods are faster and superior to existing methods. Finally, they are finishing up with the implications of their study. They are saying that their methods will remove the need for the painstaking process of visually inspecting the video for errors. As you can see, this abstract follows the standard format of topic, method, result, and implications. I hope you found the video useful. See you in the next video. If you have any questions, please drop a message below. We will answer it as soon as possible. If you are interested in watching the extended version of this training course and learn more about research and academic writing, please visit Our Learning Academy. You can find the link in the description below. If you still haven't installed Ref and Write software, please do it. It comes with referencing tools, plagiarism checkers, paraphrasing tools, an academic phrase bank, and many other useful features to help you write your research papers and thesis. You can sign up for free using the link below in the description. Finally, please subscribe to our channel to get future updates. Bye for now.